It was like a family setting. We didn't have television, we didn't have radio, we didn't have telephone, so it was natural, you know. It was fun living there.
In those days, we were happy. We had a lot of fun. Students were, some of them were very big, bigger than the teachers, and we had a lot of fun. We played a lot of games. We used to sit down around in the evening. We had no electricity. We used lantern and so forth. And when the moon is shining, we sit around the flagpole and begin to give our history about our culture. We learn some of our songs, and we used to have some great time.
Joseph Sebley, a realtor from Norwood, Pennsylvania, and Pastor Motuba Israel Harding, a retired church administrator and teacher living in Atlanta, Georgia, represent two generations of Liberians tied together by a common past and passion for a unique school that changed both their lives.
Everybody around the country for some reason wanted to come to Kornola because we have a whole lot to offer. Kornola was a lighthouse because they had good education. We had missionaries that were caring. And in fact, today, some of my friends and I were just discussing that it was a great sacrifice for the missionary to leave from here, this big country, and go to Kornola.
It's a small school just about 50 miles out of the capital of Liberia. At Kornola, which means the mouth of the Kano River, and there's a small school there. We had 150 students.
Founded in the 1940s as a boys' mission school from grades 1 to 8, Kornola grew into an Adventist boarding academy, serving many Liberian students from various faith backgrounds.
Kornola Academy is my heart. I love Kornola Academy. I love Kornola Academy, and I could give my life for Kornola Academy because that school was established to train teachers and to train pastors. And from that school, we've had pastors, we have teachers, we have some doctors who came from that school, and they are all great men. Some are dead, but they are all great men today.
But their fate would change in 1980. In a political unrest that saw over 200,000 lives lost and over 1 million displaced, Kornola Academy, once a respected and influential school in central Liberia, suffered during this unrest in the Liberian government. School properties, including the library, were left in ruins, yet Kornola Academy made its mark, even among rebel soldiers.
He was sitting down in his chair, green big chair, dark shades, green fatigue, and he asked the soldiers, why you brought this man before me for? Our church is not too far from the barracks. So he turned around in his chair. He said, don't you see that building? Seventh-day Adventist Church, Seventh-day Adventist School. This little man has money to build those buildings. Then his mouth missed. He said, this man was my teacher. He taught me in school. The knowledge I have today, this chair I sat in, he placed me in this chair. Amen! You know how I felt. I rejoiced because I was already giving hope they were going to kill me.
There were different warlords. There was like a civil war going on. And I went there during the war in 1994, in the midst of the war, and there were actually three groups of soldiers occupying the homes and the classrooms. And so the books were burned, the benches were burned for firewood, and windows were gone, doors were gone. And I could only walk down the center of the campus, but as you looked, the church was gutted out, you know, the classrooms were there and the dorms, and there's been a lot of, you know, just people in and out, and just the effects of war. It needs to be rebuilt. And the Liberian government has recognized our school, and actually they've been given a charter to build it again into a high school and also into a college if we wish.
Buildings are all just spoiled and broke down. So it's I mean, when we see the picture currently, it's just heartbreaking to see something that used to be a light.
Today, Sebley and Pastor Harding met at the gathering of Liberians at the 21st anniversary celebration of the alumni and friends of Kornola Academy at Andrews University in Berrien Springs, Michigan.
That's her.
Any resemblance?
annual event attracts former students, staff, and faculty from all walks of life into fellowship. It's an occasion for acquaintances and friendships made through the years to reminisce and rejoice over God's goodness.
I mean, just moving.
It was a wonderful festival of music, worship, and food to raise funds for rebuilding Kanala Academy.
It was Kanala Mission and Kanala Academy.
To remodel one of the buildings, I think it's one of the girls' dorms that we're talking about, is about $20,000. So you multiply that by the number of, but I mean, it could be upwards of $1 million. But once again, we want to focus on the total amount, the total effort. So what the real need right now is that if we really build this school to become a viable high school again, and also hopefully one day to build it up to be a college, it could further the work of God there in that country as a whole.
The weekend was a memorable occasion for family and friends to come together and share high hopes and aspirations for the future of Kanala Academy. Sabutuba, yeah. Sabutuba, yeah.